Hey, okay, I said I would explain how to do these in video, so here it is. Okay, determine the maximum area of the triangle in square centimeters if the sum of its base and height is 13. All right, so when I'm seeing a problem like this, I want to look for, what is it asking me? It's asking me for the max area. And what other information do I know? I know it's a triangle. So with that information, I know that the area of a triangle is base times height divided by 2. And I'm looking for that to be a maximum. And as soon as I see the word maximum, I know I'm probably looking for the vertex. Okay, I also know that its base and height combined is 13. So the base plus the height is 13. So you know when we have a regular like quadratic equation, whatever it looks like, we only have two variables, an x and a y. I said that reversed. So in this equation, we have an area, like an a, a b, and an h. We have three variables. Not good. We only want to have two max. So what we have to do here is use this information to kind of like write the area formula in terms of one variable, base or height. So let's say I isolated the base or the height. It doesn't really matter. Okay, I'm gonna isolate the height. So I'm gonna bring base to the other side. So then I know h is equal to 13 minus b. So now I know some information about the height. So I'm gonna sub in my 13 minus b in for height. Right, so now I have an equation and it's actually just in terms of two variables, area and base. So now if I were to actually graph that function, it would kind of look like this. Area would be the y, base would be the x, and it would be like a parabola that opens down, which you could see if you expanded, you'd get like negative b squared. And I'm looking for what would the base be when the area is the biggest. So in order to do that, you need to find the vertex. But just looking at this equation, right now this equation is already in factored form. So since it's in factored form, I personally, my go-to would be to find the roots, and then I know the vertex will be right in between the roots. So since it's already in factored form, I think I'm going to set area equal to 0. So that would be like right here at the roots, and I'm going to solve for b. So right off the bat, I'm going to multiply both sides by 2 because I know that 0 times 2 is still going to be 0, and these two will cancel out. So now I've got base times 13 minus base. And now, just like when I'm finding roots, I can set each bracket equal to 0, or each term equal to 0. And then I just have to isolate b. So now I found out that there's an x-intercept or a b-intercept at 0 and at 13. So now if I want to find the vertex, it's going to be right in between those two. So right in between 0 and 13, if I add them together and divide by 2, is 6.5. So I know that I will get a maximum area when my base is 6.5. So what will my height have to be? Well, my height will be equal to 13 minus the base. So my height will also be 6.5. So I'm going to have a max area when my base and height are 6.5, and my max area will be base times height divided by 2, whatever that equals, will be my max area. Okay, next one. There is a bridge in Utah. And we've got the equation of this bridge, which is this. But in meters and horizontal distance. So just like looking at an equation like this, oh, sorry, I'm just gonna switch. So h equals negative 0.043d squared plus 2.365d. Just looking at that equation, like there's no c value. So right away, I know that the y-intercept is gonna be 0 since there is no c value. And then since that's negative, I know it's gonna open down. So right away I know that Okay, wait, I don't know what I was gonna say there. Let's see what they're asking me for. So they're asking me for the maximum height of the arch. So that's gonna be the vertex. So I'm looking for the max height. And they're also asking me for the width of the arch, which are like, basically once I find the two roots, I'll be able to figure out how wide it is. Although I already know one root is gonna be zero. So you know what? I think I'm gonna use that as my strategy. I'm not gonna complete the square here. I am gonna do kind of what I did above. I'm gonna find my roots first. So I'm gonna try factoring out this guy. Okay, so this is height and this is distance. So when I'm trying to find the roots, I set h equal to zero. And then I'm gonna factor out a 0.043d. Oh, I really need a calculator right now. Okay, so what do I have left for my first term? I'll just have a d minus, because I factored out a negative. I'll get 2.365 divided by 0.043, which is 55. Okay, so I just common factored out a negative 0.043d, which means I just divided each of these terms by that. And that's what I got. So now to find the roots, I can set each of these equal to zero. So I know this one's just gonna equal zero, right? Because like if you had a negative 0.043 in front of it, I divide both sides by that, d is gonna equal zero, which I already knew, it's right here. And then this one, d minus 55 equals zero. I know that d is going to equal 55. So right away, I've already answered b. The answer to b is gonna be 55 meters. That's how wide the arch is. And now I know the maximum. Well, I don't know the max height, but I know at the max height, there will be a distance of 55 divided by 2. Because it'll be right in between the two roots. So 27.5 will be this value right here, 27.5. So to find the max height, I'm just going to sub that back into my original equation. 27.5 squared plus 2.365 times 27.5, and that's how I'll find them, the height. Sorry, I'm not gonna calculate that for you, but that's how you would do it. So yeah, just wanna make a video on those two word problems.